that you're finding enough room. It's really great to see all of the parents and friends and grandparents out here for this concert. This is always really a fun concert because you get to see so many different levels, so many great things, a lot of great music. And so we're happy that you're here. And so a couple quick announcements before we get started for you. One is, just like in the fall, if you were at the middle school concert in the fall, I had left a boy's name off my program, and you know what? It happened again. And I think it happened because he really likes me to announce his name special, so Jackson Theory, if you would stand up. Would you stand up? When you start things in a cog and then we don't quite do it, it's tough to change that. So I'm going to have to put that in tomorrow so that in the spring his name is on the program. All right, so there's Jackson. Again, we'd like to welcome you out here. We're going to start with the Star Spangled Banner. So would you please rise for our national anthem?
our high school jazz ensemble. We've been rehearsing in the morning very early, because that's what works. That was Thieves in the Temple. I gotta give Mr. Kevin Meadows some jazz credit. It's a Prince song, and Mr. Kev found that one, and I kind of like it, so it's a little funk tune. We're gonna try to play with a lot of different styles tonight. Here's a piece we played earlier in the year called Blue Flame.
Thank you.
piece. That was a piece called Groovin' High by Dizzy Gillespie, the bebop. So different styles we're trying to throw out at everyone today. We're going to close with a Latin piece. Part of the allure of jazz is it's different and interesting, and sometimes the titles are too. So we offer up El Burrito Picante and the Chamber of Doom. Yes, yes. There's actually a sequel called The Night of the Spice Burrito. Maybe next year. El Burrito Picante. And again, thank you for listening for the jazz band.
One of the great things about being a music educator is the, probably more than any other area, you get to see these kids start here at the sixth grade, go all the way up through the high school, see them improve. It's just tremendous fun. They get run over by a piano every once in a while. It's just tremendous fun. How about another hand for the jazz? these kids, you know, hold a real special spot in my heart as they progress and see them go on in music and do some things. It's very, very fun. And then sometimes as adults, I get to see them play and they come back and play at some groups that we have in the area. But it all starts here at the sixth grade. So here's our sixth graders. This is a tremendous group this year. We have a lot of fantastic players and they're so fun. We have less than we've had in the past because our class sizes keep shrinking, but what they don't have in numbers, they sure have in sound and in talent. So here's our sixth graders. They're going to do a few pieces for you.
Thank you.
things that we like to do when I like to do in class when we have a little time is to have the kids step up and do some conducting and do some different things in class. And so we have different kids come on up every so often and conduct through some songs and stuff like that and see what it sounds like from up there to start things. And then once in a while, I like to try to get a student to come on up and conduct that has done a really good job. And we had several kids in the band that did a great job. But we're going to welcome Nate Baruki up to the stage. Song, but they're not going to give me a minute because I didn't play trombones. All right, pump up another hand for the sixth grade. So our next group is usually together all the time, but in the last couple of years, Mr. So and I have tried to work it out so that we separate the seventh and eighth graders just to give them a little different experience and give the eighth graders really also a chance to come on over to the high school, see what that's like. And to see what it's like in the band room and work with Mr. Snow and to get to know him a little bit. So we have a couple pieces that we're going to do separately. So we're going to start off with our 7th graders who have been doing a fantastic job this year. This group, the 7th and 8th grade, I'll probably say it again, but when they get into the 7th and 8th grade, I just have a lot of fun with them. They're a terrific group of kids and they come on up and they're involved in so many things and it's really fun being around these guys. So here's our 7th graders, and then you'll hear our 8th graders in a moment.
I'd like to introduce the 8th grade. We're going to play a piece called Lightning. And it's been a pleasure having come over to the high school and again, try to be a little different than the combined group of the 7th graders, stretch their legs a little bit musically. And so this piece is inspired by like a storm and all the different types of things that might be in a storm. So if we do our job right, we're going to hear, of course, the storm, but we might also hear the smooth, pretty, calm parts of a storm, too. So we're excited to present to you Lightning.
Such a gracious guy and just a fantastic writer. His pieces are simplistic but beautiful, but they're also really difficult. Case in point, this one. Easy to play on paper, but to do it with expression, which is why we use this piece and try to play this piece, is always a challenge to do a slow piece like that. And this is just a beautiful example of that. So this is A Song for Friends by Larry Dan.
Thank you.
our final piece, we're going to feature our trombone section, because when you have a trombone section that you can feature, why not feature them, right? That's right. These guys are great players, and we've had a lot of fun with this piece. They have the other parts are like we get to play second fiddle to the trombone, but once in a while you got to do that. Once in a while you have to do that. So here we're going to close our portion of the concert with Sliding and Gliding. Thank you.
I am a Star Trek fan. However, I must confess that this was a student wanted to play this. I was like, okay, this sounds great. So this is a symphonic suite from Star Trek, the new movie that kind of builds on some of the older familiar themes and some of the newer themes from the movie. So we hope you enjoy Star Trek's various. I believe it's taken right from the first new movie, if you know what I mean. We're a little edgy tonight. I'd like to thank you again for coming this evening. This is the last piece that we'll do with the high school. It's been a busy 3 months, and we've only played for you 2 times tonight, and we've been doing other things, so if you want to hear what else we've been doing, Thursday night, we're hosting a solo and ensemble contest. A little strange, being a Thursday night, but just with scheduling, that is what worked best for us. So we've also been doing some woodwind ensembles, percussion ensembles, some brass ensembles, and so just juggling that schedule. It's been a lot of things to play, but it's been a lot of fun to try some new things, hasn't it? What else can we say? We all good? Okay. So we're going to play, this movie came out last year, and just immediately taken with how catchy its original music is. Last time we tried to do a movie along with while we played, we destroyed Las Vegas. For those of you that remember, if you don't remember, it was a good time. Maybe we'll do that again in the future. But anyway, we'd like to play for you selections from La La Land. But before we do, I'd like to encourage you to watch and enjoy your students clean afterwards. They're very excited to do this. And the upperclassmen are going to be keeping track of who's not helping, however the underclassmen will help. Is how that works. So again, at the end of the program today, we do need to get everything out of here as you know, life goes on tomorrow. So anyway, without further ado, La La Land.
Just hold on for a second. We're going to give the mic to Mr. Radke. You all want to hear Mr. Radke, right? Here he is.
I'm not going to sing. I just want to say thank you to all of you for being here tonight and supporting these students, your students, and all these wonderful musicians this evening. It's always amazing to me. I was just sitting there thinking about each individual student and each individual section of instruments, and they can put that sound together and make such wonderful music. Isn't that amazing? Put your hands together for another one. Their talent, your talent for passing that talent down to them, and also the talent of Mr. Cashmiddle and Mr. Snow. I was watching them conduct tonight. How about them? Again, thank you, and thank you, and thank you. And I'm going to pass the mic to you, Mr. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, you left me a lot of material. Our last song is going to be Aftermath. I also want to thank the music group. What is it? Afterburn. Sounds intense. Also, thank you, our music boosters, as well, for everything that you do for the music program. So, thank you, music boosters. Thank you, Blake, for this ready. And we do the music boosters to do a 50-50 raffle today. Tonight, excuse me, so I'm drawing this out. Oh boy. Alright, get your ticket. 760-9153. 760-9153. If you have that ticket, come find. See Matt here, maybe after the program. Well, they just don't want to come down right now. So again, thank you again for coming. We have one more piece. It is called Afterburn, and we do need to do a procedure here. And so, you ready? Ready? Get set, go. Especially with summer camps, with bringing in clinicians. We've had some clinicians come in, and it didn't work out necessarily. It was just bad weather. But thank you for our sponsorship of sending kids on a trip. We're heading to New York next Thursday, so we're very excited about that. And help helped defer some costs for that. So that's just an awesome thing when music boosters are helping bring in different experiences, helping us get to different experiences. And so we're really appreciative of that. So I think we're in position with the procedure. It worked. And we'd like to present for you the masterpiece combined called Afterburn. Don't leave unless you're satisfied. So. they have the same kind of chairs have to go on the rack, so I can't just throw them on there, even though I appreciate the energy. It has to be like chairs that go on the rack. So thank you very much. Thank you again. As sixth graders,